My name is Monte Cooper, and I'm from Georgia, and my business is banking. My S is wealthy people to help you start the bank, and my input of the bank are money, financial, people with financial degrees, workers, and credit cards. The producers are workers, managers, and construction workers. My output is investments, car loans, house loans, and savings accounts. And my customers are people who will need money out of their savings or people who need to put their money in. And my name for it is Wilshire Bank. And my slogan is money is power. Get it anytime I want.
Okay. So now we get the opportunity to give him feedback on his presentation to us and how effectively he communicated what his business does in our environment. So who's got feedback for Monte? How did he do? What did he do wrong? Exactly. So public speaking, you got to stand up. You got to speak clearly and loudly. What's next?
He didn't talk loud.
Exactly. So it didn't carry across. Did he have a good slogan, and did he define the inputs and outputs correctly?
Yes,
he did a very, very good job with that. All right. Who's ready to go next?
I'm not
done. All right. Let's go.
Do I have to look at the camera?
No. Just speak.
Right, I'm going to sit
on top of your head.
Like,
read it
that
sentence and then read it out.
All right, let's go.
My name is Isaiah Montgomery, and I'm from Fitzgerald, Georgia. And the thing that I came up with is the store is an electronical store called Liz Electrical Store. The S for suppliers is our other countries. The input is give money to the other countries. The P is for
I took it off the board so you guys can memorize it. I told you to write it down.
The P is the workers and the...
The P is the workers and the people, yeah. And the team that puts it together.
Yeah, P is the people that put it together, like workers and people from other countries that make the things. And the O is for customers happy, money, and market growing, so it can be spread all over America so other people around America will want to go to that store and buy things. And the C, the people that I want to buy it is businessmen. And the slogan is, if you want to buy stuff, come to Zay.
So it's an electronics company, right? So critique him. Tell him what he did wrong.
Well,
look down.
Your arms come.
Look down.
Then with
he did the non-man law thing. He grabbed his arm from the back like that. That ain't no good look. What else? You held your head down. You had to read from your paper. But that's part of memorization. You presenting a subject to somebody or presenting, making a presentation. You can't. You ever see the president speak? He has teleprompters that he has over to the right, and he is directly next to the camera. So it never looks like he turns his head or changes. Like he's just giving you information that he already knows. And that's what you want to be able to communicate. But best is that you already know most of this, even if you memorize a line at a time. And give yourself little small footnotes. So that you can put it out.
Also, when y'all slogan, what was your slogan?
If you want fast stuff, come today.
So, and what was your business again?
Electronics.
Any white people gonna come to your store with that kind of slogan? Yeah. You want fast stuff? Come today. You think white people gonna come to your business?
If you want good
quality,
if you want good quality, not counterfeit stuff, come today.
I'm not trying to change it. It's just something you need to think about. Right, you want to attract all people.
You want a broad audience. That money is green.
Right.
Yeah. All right. So who's ready to go next? All right, let's go.
My name is Todd Floyd Williams. I'm from Cap County.
So we do the firm handshake when we come in, right? Yeah. Why do we do the firm handshake?
To get comfortable.
To represent yourself.
Exactly. Representation of your confidence in who you are as an individual. So a company hires you to come in, and you are hired to come in and work and contribute. And you're contributing what you know up here, what you got in your head, is what we're hiring you to do. So your ability to either effectively communicate what you know or your ineffective ability will determine whether or not you stay on a job. So here you go. Hey, Charles Fulton, how are you? Good, good. There we go. So when you present that product, you've got to do it in a similar fashion, because if you don't, this guy's not going to buy it. I need him to buy it. I need you to buy it. And the only way that I can do that is if I exude confidence in the presentation. Because guess what? If you're not confident, that means the product probably isn't any good. Now, does that mean it's true? No. You just might be ineffective. But if I'm hiring you to sell the product, you've got to be able to sell the product. So sell us through your product.
That's kind
of lovely. Yes, start over.
Hi, my name is Tyler Quinn Williams. I'm from DeKalb County. I'm from Memorial Middle. And I want to own my own barber.
Your own what? I'm sorry.
My own barbershop.
Barbershop, okay.
And my company name is Your Cuts, and my slogan is Your Cuts, we need to come. You need a cut, we got you. And my supply, stressed out. Okay, my input, we need clippers, guards, trash cans, and scissors.
Mm-hmm.
And my pee, barbers, they help with to keep the shop going.
Mm-hmm.
And
you need a little boy who sweeps the floor.
Yeah, and yeah, my little son.
Yeah. What else do you need?
And I need
chairs.
Yeah, chairs.
And yeah.
TVs.
Magazines.
Food.
Oh, you have food in a barbershop.
Yeah, I have little mini grill-offs. I have, special occasion grill-offs.
You don't want to mix hair and food. That's not a good combination.
Okay, my outfits. I'm going to have big haircuts.
Okay.
That's beautiful. I'm supposed to have these located braids. Shape up and designs.
Okay.
And my C.
Everybody wants the haircut.
Need the haircut.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So if I'm doing it, if I don't know, if I haven't seen anybody's head he's cut, am I gonna go to his barbershop?
No.
Why?
Because you don't have no. He doesn't. You don't have no.
He's not like.
Advertising to see what he's able to do.
What else? Help him. Help him perfect his presentation. That's what this is about.
He's moving around a lot.
Yeah, he's moving around a lot. He's moving his arms.
He's nervous.
What's wrong with him?
He's nervous.
Okay. How does he get past the nerves?
Get the cameras there.
No. Because guess what? When there's not a camera there and you have to present, what do? He'll do the same thing. How does he get better at his presentation?
Stand up straight. Talking
about stuff. I'm going to give you an example. Put your paper down. Watch this. Put your paper down.
You need a brush or something. I have this.
Tell us.
Listen.
Give us a minute speech on the most important thing your mother has ever done for you.
Okay, well, the most important thing my mom ever done for me was keep me alive and clothe me and have a roof on my head. Also, she had kicked with me, like a sister, your friends.
Stop. Do you believe? Yeah, you see the confidence, his shoulders go back, he'll fight you over a mama, because he knows that. if he knew that material that way, it would be a similar output.
We got Ms. Jackson coming in. Ms. McMahon wants to know if y'all can move it to the concert train.
Okay.
Okay.
For the next week. I mean, she's going to be here at 10.
Okay. Okay. So you see the way that your body language changed, his vocal tone, the way he enunciated his words, and the confidence in which he spoke was totally different because he knew the information. He knows his mind. So you got to be able to know your information that you're presenting in that same fashion. Okay, so we got three gentlemen going to present their products to us today. And we're going to start first with you. So, let's go. Introduce yourself and tell us about your product.
Well, my name is Javon Hill. I am 12 years old, and I go to Memorial Middle School. Well, today I'm going to tell you about my new product. It's called Transformers. And, well, our slogan is that we'll transform your dirty things into clean. So, well, you can get it at many types of places. The places I can tell you now is CVS, Rite Aid, Walmart, Walgreens, Target, and well.
Okay, first, tell us about who are the suppliers of your process. Who supplies you with the stuff that you need to make your product?
Well, my team, of course. My factory.
No, I mean you sell a product. Is that correct? Okay. So, what's in your product? What are the components of your product?
Chlorine, bleach, so the type of blue spray.
Mm-hmm. So where do you get those materials from to mix together to make your special magic formula?
I get it from Georgia.
Okay, that's fine. So continue on with your presentation.
Well, I'm going to tell you that the shipping is free, and you can...
Internationally or in the United States?
Like, in the United States.
Okay.
And you can order it off j2ks.com.
Okay.
And if you don't have any internet access, you can just call the company, 404-687-202-47. If you want me to say it again, 404-687-202-47. And, well, like I said, this item will just, like, if you have any type of stain, you can just rub it off.
Okay, so let's identify what he's doing wrong. Yeah. But the issue is what is he doing wrong?
He's pausing. Like, he's slurring his words so he can't talk.
No, he's got real good enunciation. The problem is that he's moving, he's dancing a little bit. That's a no-no.
So we can still walk around the room.
So you've got to walk effectively. If you're talking to this guy, you got to go to him and say, da la la la. You come back to him, here's what I'm doing. Everything has to have a purpose to it. That's a lot of wasted effort. And not that it's going to exhaust you, but the issue is that you're dancing around and it's a sign of nervousness. So you got to be real comfortable with what you're presenting. Now, you did a really good job on your product. You did a really good job. You didn't know some of your supplies and some of your other things. So, number one, the supplier to your product, you make a product that's bleach, blue coloring, and something else, right? But it's a magic product. Where do you get the raw materials to come into your lab or manufacturing area and put those things together? You get them from Walmart, you buy them from some other major supplier, and you get your bleach from somewhere that you can get at a real low cost, right? You bring them to your spot. Those are your inputs. Your inputs are the materials that you need to supply to make the product, right?
Mm-hmm.
The process is... Who are the people that put it together? If you're the owner, are you the guy that's doing all this? No, you got workers. So how do you control that those workers are putting in the right amount to make sure that your product is good? You got to give them, you got to teach them, you got to put controls in place. So the person who on that assembly line that you got mixing your product is going to put so much a volume of chlorine, so much a volume of blue stuff, so much volume of water. And if it's consistent, you put out a consistent product. They put in too much bleach, guess what? I'll put something on your shirt to eat a hole in it. So you got to have the controls in place. You got to be able to manage the people and the process that makes your product. So then you look at what's the output. The output is the actual magic cleaner, right? Mm-hmm. And then who are your customers? You said it earlier.
Oh, like the places that I use.
You got to say it.
Like Target, Walmart, CVS, right?
CVS. And who buys it from them? Women.
Women.
Women. Because women usually run the functional household. Even if they work, they still manage all of the cleaning and stuff like that, usually. The men help out, but the women usually orchestrate it. And they'll orchestrate it by purchasing certain things. Alright, so you did good. Next up. Let's go. Present your product to us, please.
My name is Darion Johnson. I go to Memorial Middle School. I am 13 years old. And the name of my store is Best Buy, and you can find it anywhere in California.
The name of your store is what?
No, not Best Buy, but Best Equipment.
Best Equipment, okay. What is it that you sell?
I sell, like, all sports utilities, like basketball, footballs, ankle braces, et cetera. And
you're in the middle of a presentation to executives who are going to either purchase your product or dismiss you and say that we don't want to buy it. So it's kind of important that you convince us that you have a good product.
And, well, I get my parts from Canada and we make them here in California. And, like, our team, our group needs to work on making them faster because they're coming off the shelves, so.
Okay, so now you're going through your SIPOC, right? Mm-hmm. Who supplies you? Canada does.
Mm-hmm.
What's the input?
The input, like, well, for footballs and stuff, pigskins and all that, and string.
So are you buying the footballs already made up, or are you buying the materials, the raw materials, and putting them together?
Buying the raw materials and putting them together.
Now, what does that change? Is there an increased savings for you as a company if you buy the football materials and put them together?
Yes, sir.
Versus buying them whole?
Well, I figure that if we already make them ourselves, because we make them good, we just take someone to make them.
But is it a labor cost involved in you putting them together yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that's okay for you. It doesn't have to be. I'm just asking you.
Yes, it's okay.
All right, good. So what else? No. So what did he do wrong? What did he do wrong in his presentation?
He did tell us what the footballs and stuff are made out of.
I think I stopped too long. I hesitated.
Hesitated. You moved around a little bit. So what we're trying to do is get the public speaking portion of it down, because this is a big part of you pitching a product. We all sell in some form or another in business. Every job you have will be some form of selling. Even if you're not directly selling a product or a book or whatever or a service, you're going to sell it in some form because you have to have those meetings. Mr. Kinsey has a sale. When those parents come in and they're irate and they're going crazy or they have unrealistic expectations, he has to come back and bring them back to reality and say, 1, 2, 3, 4, here are the things that your child needs to work on, because here's the patterns that we see. But once again, he's selling that Memorial Middle School has a good product, they've got a good formula for educating children, but here's how you reach your objective as a parent. And here's how he's going to help you reach it. That's selling. And if he can't do that effectively, his life is going to be pretty rough. But he does it very effectively. He does it realistically based. He tells you guys, hey, listen, here's what you have to get. And if you don't get it, you know, it's fortunate that he's a basketball coach, because he understands performance. And performance is a big part of being successful in any career. You've got to be able to perform. And if you're not performing on a given day, guess what? You come out the game. You might be a great basketball player, but you've got to come out the game because you can't give us the best opportunity to be successful. All right, let's go.
My name is Akeem Williams. I'm 14, going to Movermore Middle School, and I sell hooks. I have factories all over the place. My slogan is hook it up. So when you need a hook, when you fisherman's love, you got to be a fisherman. You need hooks, correct? So you need hooks. I have a factory in Conyers, Florida, Alabama. You can get them anywhere in the USA.
What's your slogan, man?
Hook it up.
Okay, hook it up is your. Now, give us some more details on your product.
We get our supply from Florida. We have a factory in Florida to get all our metal from, and all of my employees get 100 hours study on the stuff that we need to do.
Okay.
Our stuff get a variability. Everything. Everybody have different jobs, and once you get a hook, you'll be fantastic. You'll be fantastic at your work.
Okay. So now let's go back and look at the formula that we're looking at before, the S and the I and the P, O and C, and you define where those things come at from your company. So supplies, where do you get your supplies from?
A factory in Florida.
Okay. So Florida supplies you with the metal to do your hooks. And then you bring that raw material in and you have a team of people that actually make the hooks. So you manufacture the hooks from raw steel or iron or whatever?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So your inputs are the steel, the things, the materials you use to make the hooks.
Yes, sir.
What is the P? And how do you control the P? Help him out. What is the P?
Process.
The process. So the people who make the hooks for you, the people who work on the assembly line, who actually design and form the hooks. How do you control that they're making good hooks?
I have this pan. It's the shape of a hook. So you pour the liquid metal in the pan.
Good.
And once it dries, you have a form of a hook. We have all kinds of hooks. Big, small, medium.
So you have this one pan or you have a group of pans?
We have a whole bunch of pans. Everybody get assigned a different type of hook and they have a pan for that particular hook.
So how do you know that the pans are identical? How do you know that all the pans that you have are the same?
I do. I have a factory in South Carolina that gives me the pans.
Okay. But how do you, as an owner, make sure that the hooks are the same size? Because there's a chance that the pans that they make might not be the same size. How would you ensure that?
I'll test them sometimes. I'll put liquid metal in each one to see if the hooks are the same size.
So you measure the hooks?
I do.
Okay, good. So your output is what? What is your output?
Selling hooks.
The hooks. The hooks themselves. Okay. Who are your customers?
Any people that love the fish. You can give it any stores, Walmart.
Who would be one of your main people that you sell hooks to, though? Think about that. The place up by Discovery Mills Mall that you might think about. The outdoorsman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In tackle stores.
Exactly. So what did he do wrong? Let's give him a critique.
Hesitation to his information.
Did he seem nervous?
Yeah. Well, not really. He spoke loud. He spoke very loud.
I give him that. He came across with the vocals and he was clear in his speech. But he's doing this. He's like a pendulum. He's about to be crazy. So, wringing your hand, that's another sign of nervousness. So this is an opportunity for you guys to really chime down and look at the small things that you do that will be distraction in you selling or delivering your product. And your product is the knowledge that you know about what it is you're speaking about.
Don't y'all do presentations in class?
Yes.
I just made a presentation on the liquid hook.
So this will also help you with that, because they don't critique y'all in class.
Yeah.
So now probably what you did today is probably what you did when you did your presentation. Fiddle, swinging, you know, that makes people dizzy after a while. I'm like, dizzy watching you keep swinging. So those are things you just, you know, you get better on as you do it more. And as we go through this process and this program, by the end, you'll be very good.